Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I decided to do a Valentine's Day look for you guys. Valentine's Day is in less than a month and I decided that I was going to do a few Valentine's Day looks for you guys. I feel like I'm saying Valentine's a lot, but I decided to do a few of them this month for you before Valentine's Day shows up around the corner. And so I'm going to do a few natural ones, a few more dramatic and extra ones that are more glamorous, and then I also am probably going to do some that involve a little bit of art, maybe like my Gucci tutorial. I might throw in a few hearts onto my face, show you how to draw something Valentine's Day themed on your face. So I'm just going to look into a few ideas for that and make a few videos for you for Valentine's Day that you can enjoy watching, and maybe it'll give you some ideas on how you want to do your makeup for that. And so yeah, if you want to see how I did today's Valentine's Day look, then please just keep watching. So I'm just going to start off by priming my eyes, and I'm using my Urban Decay Eyeshadow Primer Potion. And I actually haven't done this in a while. I started priming my eyes with just regular concealer, but I decided, you know what? We're gonna get back to doing the primer instead of the concealer just to see if we still like it. Prime and prep, ladies. Prime and prep. So now that we primed our eyes, we're just going to prime our face, and I got a new primer. It's by Smashbox, just like my old one, but this is the Photo Finish Primerizer with Moisturizer in one, and it has hyaluronic acid and niacinamide. I probably totally got that wrong. So I've been using this one lately, and I think it works probably better. So we're just going to rub that into our face. And then we're going to let that sit, and then we're going to get on to our eyeshadow for our look today. I'm going to start off by going into my Huda Beauty palette, and I'm going to pick up the shade Eden, and I'm going to put that all over my lid. So I just decided to move in a little bit closer so you can see a little bit better my eyes, because I noticed in some of my videos you can't really see my eyes very well while I'm doing it. So I just decided to move in just a little bit closer. So now I'm just going to go in with the shade Oud. Pretty sure that's how you pronounce it, but it's that shade right there. And I'm going to place that all over my crease. Now going in with the shade Musk, I'm going to place that on top of those two colors and blend those two colors together. I want to do a cut crease for this look, so I'll go in with my concealer and a little concealer brush. I'm going to do that trick that you guys would see if you saw my last video. I'm just putting a little bit of concealer on the bottom near your lash line and then looking up, and it'll place the top of where your crease should be. And then just connect the lines. And this is the look. Definitely not bad. So what I want to do is I want to do a pink cut crease, so I'm going to go into my LA Nudes palette, and I'm going to pick up this shade right here. It's just a nice soft pink shade, and I'm going to place that all over the lid. And I know, our eyes look a mess, but do you really think you're going to, like, stay looking a mess? Like, no, girl, chill. Calm down, you're going to make it look good. Make it look real good. Real good. So now I'm just going to go back into my Huda Beauty palette, and I'm going to pick up the shade Oud again, and I'm going to just deepen up that crease. Now I'm going to go into my Huda Beauty Mod Obsessions palette and pick up the hot pink shade that they have and put it in the outer part of the cut crease. Going back into the Huda Beauty palette, I'm going to pick up Cashmere, and I'm going to place that on my inner corner area. So now I'm just going to take a makeup wipe and clean up the edges a little bit. So now I'm going to take my white eyeliner and I'm going to place it right in the crease area. So just like a pop of color. Now I'm going to take a black lip liner and just wing out my eyeliner like normal. Now I'm going to go in to the Anastasia Beverly Hills Prism palette. I'm going to pick up the shade Obsidian and I'm going to place it over my black liner just to smoke it out a little bit. And this will get a little bit messy, but it's okay because we're going to clean it up. I really look kind of scary right now. Now going back in with a wet makeup remover towelette thing, yeah, we're going to clean up our edges. Now going back in with the liquid liner, I'm just going to sharpen up the edge a little bit and make sure it goes to a sharp point. So for foundation, I'm just going to mix my Cover FX Enhancement Drops with my NARS Natural Radiant Foundation, and the custom drops are in the shade Celestial. So now I'm just going to go in and conceal under my eyes, down my nose, my chin, my forehead, you know, the usual. So I really need to do my eyebrows because I feel like I look like a ghost. But before we do that, I'm going to go ahead and add some translucent powder underneath my eyes. While that sits on my face, then I'm going to do my eyebrows because I really look like a ghost right now with no eyebrows. So I'm just going to do the same process I always do with my eyebrows, just using my Anastasia products and going over it with my NYX brow gel. So I'm just going to skip ahead and avoid showing you guys this part because you guys can look at one of my old videos if you want to see how I do my eyebrows, or I might make a video specifically for how to do my eyebrows. But as of right now, you guys can just go back and look at one of my old videos to see how to do my eyebrows. And hallelujah, thank goodness we have eyebrows again. So now I'm just going to wipe away my bake and pat it more into my skin and blend it. Now we're looking so much better. Okay. So now I'm just going to go in and bronze my face. I'm using my Becca bronzer today. And I chose this one because it has a little bit of shimmer in it. So like I said, I wanted my face to be a little bit dewy looking. So I'm just going to use this one and apply it to my cheeks. Going into my Urban Decay Naked Skin, I'm going to take the second darkest shade and I'm going to contour my nose and under my lip. Now going into my Morphe blush palette, I'm going to take the peachy shade right here and apply that to the apples of my cheeks. So moving on to the lower lash line of our eyes, I'm going to go back into my Huda Mob Obsessions palette and take that hot pink shade from earlier and place that all over my waterline. So we definitely need some mascara, so I'm just going to curl my lashes and apply my Lancome one. I have a new Lancome one because I lost my other one, because I lose everything. I'm going to go in and add some false lashes, and I'm so excited for my false lashes today, you guys! I am using the Huda Beauty Samantha number 7 lashes, and I am so excited. Honestly, didn't even know that Huda came out with lashes, and I was honestly shook. Like, I walked into Sephora and I was going to go get one of her palettes because the one that I had, the black, and it busted, and it kind of really upset me, but it's okay. So instead I ended up getting a highlighter palette, which we're also going to use today. And then beside the highlighter palette, I saw these lashes and I was like, bitch. Like, they have lashes. Like, that girl doing everything. She's my favorite makeup artist, you guys. I love Huda. Everything about Huda. I was shook. These are my new favorite lashes. That's just how it is. Like, seriously obsessed right now. Like, can we take a minute? My lashes look amazing. Okay. Now that we had our moment, I'm just going to go in with another top coat of mascara. Okay, I'm sorry guys, I'm just really obsessed with these lashes right now, so I need to chill. So now we're going in with the highlight. So just to intensify this highlight a little bit more, I'm going to go back in with my enhancement drops. I'm going to place it, or I'm going to place my highlight on top of it. I said, ladies, I want to look glowy as fuck for this look. So now it's time, my lovelies. We're going in with the Huda Beauty 3D Highlight Palette. And oh my god, these colors, you guys. These colors, oh my god. So I want to go in with... what color? Okay, so I'm stuck between Santorini and Ibiza, but I think I'm leaning more towards Santorini. So I'm just going to go in with that and apply it right over that. I'm shook. Huda. Huda is coming through with our makeup line. Now I need to do my lips. So I'm just going to go in with my Estee Lauder lipstick, and this is in the shade 100, which is called Blase Buff. Pretty sure that's how you pronounce that. If not, I'm sorry. But it's just a really pretty nude color, and I'm going to put it all in my lips. That I really love about this lipstick is it, like, look at the shape. Like, I don't know if you can see that. Like, look at the shape. Sorry, my hands have eyeliner on them. Yep. But, like, it's, like, pointed and, like, it's not, like, your normal lipstick shape. I don't know. It's just that, like, you can line your lips easily with it and put it on perfectly. It's just, I like this. Okay. So this is just literally the perfect nude to me, guys. And I do happen to know that this product does stain your lips a little bit. It's a little bit harder to get off, so it shouldn't go off throughout the day. You should be able to drink your tea, your water, your anything. You should be able to eat. I recently got these products, but I did try them out, and they are pretty hard to get off. So I feel like it should stay on all throughout the day, and you shouldn't really have any problems. So, but isn't that just the perfect nude? Like, this is new. This is my new favorite nude, and I know that I'm not usually one for lipsticks anymore. I'm more of a liquid person, but Estee Lauder, you brought me back to lipsticks. So to finish off this look, we have to set our face with a setting spray, and I recently came in touch with Evian. Is that how you pronounce it? Evian? Can I say Evian? The only two ingredients are nitrogen and water, and so it's literally like you don't have any chemicals in it. It's literally just nitrogen and water going on your face. And it's supposed to be very hydrating. I have used it, I want to say, for the past 4 days, I want to say. And I'm just using it throughout the day. Like, even if I'm not even wearing makeup, I'll just spray it on my face, and my face will literally feel way more hydrated. So I definitely recommend this to anybody. It's literally just something to hydrate your face. And with it being winter, my face does get a little bit dry. I'm very happy that I bought it because it has been a lifesaver this winter for me. Yep, okay. We're done now. Yep.